Hello students, this is Dr. A. S. Iyer. I welcome you all for the course on finite element method in civil engineering. Our today's topic is types of isoparametric element. In the last class, we had discussed the definition of isoparametric element along with the concept of mapping element and parent element. Now in this class, we will discuss the different types of isoparametric elements. So there are three subclasses, or there are three types of isoparametric elements you can say. First is simply isoparametric element, second subparametric element, and third superparametric elements. We will discuss all these three types one by one with the suitable example. So first, isoparametric elements. In isoparametric element, the same number of nodes is used to define geometry of element as well as displacement field of the element. Understand, if the same number of nodes is used to define geometry as well as displacement, those elements are called as isoparametric element. For example, to understand in a better way, if you consider one example, okay, so if you take one example of three noded bar element, this is bar element with the three nodes. Now if you want to represent the geometry of bar element, geometry means what? The Cartesian coordinates of any point of the bar element, that is called as geometry. And second, if you want to define displacement field of the bar element, means u is equal to displacement at any point of the bar element, that is u. So if you want to define geometry or displacement field, okay, so if you use the same number of nodes, for example, geometry means x coordinate of any point. If x is equal to n1 x1 plus n2 x2 plus n3 x3, it means three nodes are used to define the geometry, node number 1, 2 and 3, right? If three nodes are used to represent the geometry and the same three nodes are used to represent the displacement, u is equal to n1 u1 plus n2 u2 plus n3 u3, where u1, u2, u3 are the displacements of three nodes, u1, u2, u3 are the displacement of three nodes, and x1, x2, x3 are the Cartesian coordinates of three nodes, right? So what we have done, we represent the geometry with x and represent the displacement by u. So to represent the geometry as well as displacement, we have used all three nodes, that is n1, n2, n3 shape functions of node number 1, node number 2 and node number 3. So x is equal to n1 x1 plus n2 x2 plus n3 x3, and u equal to n1 u1 plus n2 u2 plus n3 u3. It means same number of nodes are used to represent the geometry as well as displacement, and those number of nodes are 3. So 3 nodes are used to represent the geometry as well as displacement. So this is called as isoparametric element. If the same number of nodes is used to define geometry as well as displacement, the element is called as isoparametric element. Okay. Second type is subparametric element. Okay. So if the elements in which less number of nodes is used to define geometry, less number of nodes are used to define geometry compared to the number of nodes used to define displacement. Understand, whatever number of nodes are used to represent the geometry, that number is less than the number of nodes used to define the displacement. Such elements are called as subparametric elements. Such elements are called as subparametric element. For example, again, if you consider the same three noded bar element, and these are the expressions for geometry as well as displacement. So look at this. Now geometry is represented using only two nodes, x is equal to n1 x1 plus n2 x2. Okay, it means only two nodes are used to represent the geometry, and whereas u is equal to n1 u1 plus n2 u2 plus n3 u3, it means three nodes are used to represent the displacements. So it means number of nodes used to represent the geometry is less than the number of nodes used to represent the displacement. So such elements are called as subparametric elements. Okay, again I'll repeat it. If the elements in which less number of nodes is used to define geometry compared to the number of nodes used to define displacements, the elements is called as subparametric element. Okay, so two nodes are used here to represent the geometry and three nodes are used here to represent the displacement. Third type, superparametric element. It is exactly opposite to the subparametric element. See here. What is that superparametric? The elements in which less number of nodes is used to define displacement compared to the number of nodes used to define geometry. So now number of nodes used to define displacements are less compared to number of nodes used to define the geometry. For example, here again using the same example of three noded bar element, if three nodes are used to represent the geometry, that is x is equal to n1 x1 plus n2 x2 plus n3 x3. And only two nodes are used to represent the displacement, that is u equal to n1 u1 plus n2 u2. It means number of nodes used to represent the displacement are less than the number of nodes used to represent the geometry. Such elements are called as superparametric element. This is superparametric element. Okay, such elements are called as superparametric elements. Okay, these are the three types of isoparametric element, that is isoparametric element, subparametric element and superparametric element. With the help of a simple example of three noded bar element, you can explain. You can consider one more example of two dimensional element. For example, if you consider this, one rectangular element is there, okay, with the eight nodes. Now if you look at these three figures, this is figure number 1, 2 and 3. In this three figure, rectangular box is used to represent, these nodes are used to represent the geometry. Okay, this rectangular box represent that nodes used to define geometry, and solid circle represent nodes used to define displacement. Okay, for example, if you consider the first figure here, all eight nodes are used to represent or define geometry as well as displacement. Okay, it means this is isoparametric element, right? This is isoparametric element. Eight number of nodes are used to define geometry and eight number of elements are used to define the displacement. Now if you look at this, there are eight solid circular nodes but only four rectangular nodes, boxes. It means these four corner nodes are used to represent the geometry. Only four corner nodes are used to represent the geometry, whereas all eight nodes are used to represent the displacement. It means number of nodes used to represent the geometry are less than number of nodes used to represent the displacement. So it is called as subparametric element. And if you look at here, figure number 3, there are eight rectangular boxes and only four solid circles. It means these four corner nodes are used to represent the displacement. Only four nodes are used to represent the displacement. And eight nodes are used to represent the geometry. And eight nodes are used to represent the geometry. It means number of nodes used to define displacements are less than number of nodes used to represent the geometry. This is called as superparametric element. Okay, this is for 2D example. And this is three noded bar is a 1D example to understand the types of isoparametric elements. Okay, I'll repeat again if you want to just recall the definitions again, right? We'll go to the first slide. Yes, so there are three types of isoparametric element. First is isoparametric element, second is subparametric element, and third is superparametric element. So one by one, if you want to discuss this, if the same number of nodes is used to define geometry as well as displacement, it is called as isoparametric element. So if you consider one three noded bar element, here Okay, three nodes are there. So all three nodes, if you use to represent the geometry, that is x equal to n1 x1 plus n2 x2 plus n3 x3. And again, same three nodes are used to represent the displacement u equal to n1 u1 plus n2 u2 plus n3 u3. This is called as isoparametric, right? But if you use the less number of nodes to, if you use less number of nodes to define the geometry, right, compared to the number of nodes used to define displacement. If number of nodes are less in geometry, it is called as subparametric element. Okay, it means only two nodes are used here to define the geometry, n1 x1 plus n2 x2, right? And three nodes are used to represent the displacement, that is n1 u1 plus n2 u2 plus n3 u3. So it is called as subparametric element. And if you make it opposite, if less number of nodes are used to define displacement compared to number of nodes used to represent the geometry. If number of nodes are less in displacement, it is called as superparametric element. This is superparametric element. So in that case, with the same example, if you consider geometry is represented with the help of three nodes, x is equal to n1 x1 plus n2 x2 plus n3 x3, and displacement is represented by only two nodes, u equal to n1 u1 plus n2 u2, right? And same, you can write for the rectangular element, 2D element. So this is the rectangular element with the 8 nodes are there. So 8 nodes, this rectangular box represent nodes used to define the geometry, and solid circle nodes are used to define the displacement. So here if you look at the first figure, 8 box, 8 rectangular boxes are there and 8 solid circles are there. It means the 8 nodes are used to represent the geometry, and the same 8 number of nodes are used to represent the displacement. So first type is called as isoparametric element. In the second figure, there are only 4 rectangle box and 8 solid circular. It represents that less number of nodes are used to represent the geometry compared to number of nodes used to represent the displacement. This is called as subparametric element. And in third figure, if you look at, there are 8 rectangular boxes and 4 solid circles, represent that 4 nodes are used to represent the displacement and 8 nodes are used to represent the geometry. This is called as superparametric element. So these are the three types of isoparametric element. I hope all of you have understand what is types of isoparametric formulation. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.